Hello everyone. Welcome to Corning's Community Broadband University Series. I'm Barry Walton. Today I'm kicking off a two-part series talking about Make Ready. So before I get into talking about Make Ready of telecommunications, let's talk about something we're all kind of familiar with. As you can see, I'm standing in my kitchen area, and I've been doing a lot of work making the kitchen area ready for my new kitchen cabinets. So there are a lot of dependencies that have to be done before the new kitchen cabinets can be installed. Electrical had to be moved, some plumbing had to be moved, a beam behind me had to be put in place. So that's what I've been doing to get my kitchen ready for the cabinets to arrive. So how does that kind of overlay to what we're talking about when we talk about make ready for pole lines? Well, pole line, to attach a fiber cable, you have to determine, is the pole line capable of supporting a new attachment to the pole line? And how you go about that is, if you don't own the poles, then there is a requirement with the pole owner that you submit what they call a make ready application. And basically what they will do, they'll ask for what are you looking to attach, how big, how small, the various weights and things like that. And then you submit a request that would go into the pole owner. And what they're trying to achieve and determine, based on your requirements, we're going to look at the existing pole line and see what they have to do to make it ready to accept a new attachment. So once I've received your application, a couple of things I start looking at. Start looking at the overall pole line and to determine, is there structurally the capability to support another attachment? And basically the fiber cable gets attached to the various poles. So they'll do some pole assessments and determine the strength of the pole line to ensure that it will support the additional load that's going to be put on once this cable is placed. And what may come out of it, they may determine that, oh, in order to add another attachment, the pole line may need to be beefed up. And that may mean having some poles replaced to bigger poles. Other things that they'll do as well during the make-ready process is they'll look at the existing infrastructure, what's on the poles already. So in this particular case, we have a telephone cable, communications cable already on this pole line. And they're going to take a look at it on a couple aspects. They're going to look at it and see what the separation between the telecommunications cable is and what the power utilities is. And what they're looking for is to ensure that that separation meets the various industry standards from a safety perspective, that there is enough separation between the two so a technician can work safely without endangering their life by working in too close to the power. The other thing they're looking for as well, they'll look to ensure that cable has a proper ground separation. And again, what this is, if there happened to be a road or a driveway, well, if that cable was too low, then there's a high probability that a truck could possibly go through, hit that cable, and possibly actually tear down some of the poles. So those are some of the things they're looking for. The other things they'll look for on the existing communications lines as well will be the down guy. And on this particular case, we have a down guy that supports the cable that anchors the pole line. And the down guy is broken, and that would have to be fixed before they would take and accept your request to put a fiber cable on the poles. So what happens when they run into a situation when there isn't enough clearance between these two? Well, they have a couple options. One is, if there's room on the pole, to lower the cable down, and by lowering the cable down, they'll now brought this cable back into spec to be safe to be able to work on. However, they need to as well calculate, by dropping that cable, do I now lower that cable that a truck is going to cover, catch it? So they'll look at that from that aspect. 9 times out of 10, there's a pretty good probability they can move the cable around. But in the cases where they can't, it could very well mean adding taller poles that will enable for everything to be moved up and to create the proper separations between the power and as well the ground. So those are a couple of things in terms of what they'll be looking at in terms of what's already on the pole. Other things that they will look for as well is the condition of the poles. And in some cases, a lot of the poles have been out there for a great number of years and they've started to rot. And in this particular case, we have a pole that is rotten, and the only fix for that is to replace the pole. Other things that they'll be looking for as well will be, is there any trees up amongst the communications lines or the power lines? If there is, then those would be identified as things that would have to be addressed to make this pole line suitable for you to attach your new fiber optic cable. Could be as well that they may have to move this cable around a little bit within the communication space to allow you to place your fiber cable too. So that would be another case of a make ready. So overall, those are the things that typically a pole owner will look at when you submit an application to attach your fiber cable to their pole, will be those various aspects. And typically what happens, they'll do an assessment, they'll figure out in terms of what the fix is. And typically what they'll do, they'll send you back a response to your request to attach the cable, and they will say, oh, by the way, these are the things that need to be addressed before we can give you permission or a permit to attach your cable. So the key thing is, when you're working with the pole owners, clearly understand what their requirements are for you to provide them to assess the pole line of what you're going to be putting on the pole line, and as well, fully understand the timeline of how long it will take for them to do their work, so you can plan your project accordingly in terms of what you're trying to achieve with bringing fiber broadband to your community. And as the last piece as well, truly understand what the costs are in terms of what you have to pay versus what they are going to pay. I hope you found this session beneficial to you here today. I will be having another session that will talk a little bit more about some things to hopefully move the make ready process along a little quicker, and I'll be sharing that in the next video. Again, thank you very much for your time today. Have a great one.